ఇప్పుడు కేంద్ర మంత్రి నిర్మలా సీతారామన్ లైవ్లో మాట్లాడుతున్నారు, ఇప్పుడు చూద్దాం.
Clinical trials, bioanalytical studies, all of them come under that broad category of R&D services. So we have given a notification under Section 13 of IGST Act, notifying the place of supply of specified R&D products. Provided by, and these are provided by Indian pharma companies to foreign service recipients as the place of effective use and enjoyment of a service, that is location of the service recipient. So that is for export promotion, particularly from the R&D areas. For export promotion, the GST Council decided to clarify that the place of supply of chip design software, R&D services provided by Indian companies to foreign clients by using sample test kits in India is the location of the service recipient, and again under Section 1313A of IGST Act 2017 is not applicable for determining the place of supply in such cases. So that's all about export promotion related to services. I go to the miscellaneous category. The Council decided to allow the registered authors an option, registered authors, book writers and so on. So to allow the registered authors an option to pay GST on royalty charged from publishers under forward charge and observe regular GST compliance. For book writers and authors, this is now being extended on an optional basis. Those authors who want to use, those registered authors who want to use an option to pay GST, they don't want an exemption, to pay GST on royalty charged from publishers under forward charge and observe regular GST compliance. Next is to notify grant of liquor license by state governments against payment of license fee as a no supply to remove implementational ambiguity on the subject. So it will be treated as no supply. Then next is to exempt services related to FIFA, which I've already read out, under 17 Women's World Cup 2020, similar to existing exemption given under FIFA under 17 World Cup 2017. The goods was read out earlier, now I'm reading the services. The next category, which is not very many more, rationalization, trade facilitation measures to allow payment of GST on securities lending service under reverse charge mechanism at the merit rate of 18% to clarify that GST on securities lending service for period prior to the RCM period, which is the reverse charge mechanism period, shall be paid on forward charge basis. IGST shall be payable on supply of these services, and in cases where CGST, SGST or UTGST have been paid, such taxpayers will not be required to pay tax again. So that's a clarification. The last point under this category is to allow reverse charge mechanism to suppliers paying GST at 5% on renting of vehicles from registered person other than body corporates, LLPs and proprietorship, when services provided to body corporate entities. So I'll read this again. To allow the reverse charge mechanism to suppliers paying GST at 5% on renting of vehicles from registered persons other than those which are body corporates, which is like LLPs and proprietorship, when services provided to body corporate entities, when they provided for the body corporates. Just last two clarifications. The Council decided to clarify the scope of the entry services of exploration, mining or drilling of petroleum crude or natural gas or both. There was also a decision related to that. So they have tried to clarify the scope of entry under this category. The Council also has decided to clarify taxability of passenger service fee PSF, and user development fee, which is UDF, levied by airport operators. The council, I'm repeating that point, the council has also decided to clarify taxability of passenger service fee, PSF, and user development fee, UDF, levied by airport operators. So now it is proposed that these notifications...
ఈ వీడియో మీకు నచ్చినట్లయితే లైక్ చేయండి, షేర్ చేయండి. మరిన్ని వీడియోల కోసం మా ఛానల్ సబ్స్క్రైబ్ చేయండి.